We've come a long way in understanding how our bodies work. However, there are still mysteries yet to be explained. Why do you yawn? What is the appendix actually for? Why do only men find farts funny? We're going to talk about 20 things your body does that we don't know why, and as we go through our list, things are going to get stranger and stranger. Starting with number 20, we're going to talk about boobs. There are a few attributes for male and female breasts that we don't quite understand. For example, all mammals have some form of breasts. This is because mammals tend to take care of their young after they're born. Breasts are effective delivery devices for feeding a young infant. However, only human females have enlarged breasts even when they're not rearing offspring. This is extremely strange because in the evolutionary scheme of things, having constantly large breasts can be an inconvenience, get in the way, and may even send the wrong signals. Most people think that the permanently large breasts of human females actually attract men. However, in many cultures, men do not find large breasts attractive, so this seems unlikely. Another theory is that the constantly large breasts of human females may have to do with the large brains of human offspring. It's thought that the hormones created in the breasts promote fat storage that gets released into the milk when the mother breastfeeds, making the milk extra nutritious. This has not been proven yet, so as of right now, we have no idea why human females have enlarged breasts throughout their life. And speaking of boobs, number 19 has to do with male breasts. We don't fully understand why males have nipples at all. Think about it, nipples are used as a way for babies to suckle milk from the mother's breasts. Since males can't produce milk, there's no reason for them to have nipples. All the male nipple really does is confuse the baby if they start sucking on it and nothing comes out. Hopefully you're still excited to learn more about what we don't know about our own bodies. But if at this point you're yawning, then you're already ahead of the game. Number 18 on our list is, why do we yawn? We don't know. We do know that yawning tends to occur when we're tired or bored. We might start to yawn when we see others doing it. In fact, I bet since you've heard the word yawn a few times already, you might even be doing this mysterious act right now. And if not, I bet you're definitely holding in a yawn. But what's the purpose of yawning? Originally, scientists thought yawning was a way to get more oxygen to the brain and therefore make the body less tired. But this does not seem to be the case. A more recent research might suggest that yawning is a way to cool off the brain. The yawn circulates cooler blood up to the brain to help lower the temperature in the skull. This is still being researched and many scientists disagree with the idea, but at least it is one explanation for why we yawn. Other scientists suggest yawning is a form of communication. This is why when one person yawns, people around them start to as well. Long ago, in humans' ancient past, yawning may have been a way to signal to the group that it was time to rest. If everyone was yawning and felt tired, then it was time to stop. There is always safety in numbers, and contagious yawns may have been a way to keep the group together. Number 17 is another form of contagious behavior that we don't quite understand. Laughing. We laugh when something is funny, or maybe if we're extremely uncomfortable, but why do we do this? Laughing may have the same root cause as yawning, in the sense that it's a way to make sure a group of people are on the same page. It has been hypothesized that the reason we laugh and that laughter is contagious because humans are social creatures. We want to fit in with a group, and laughter may be a form of empathy to connect with others in a social setting. When we laugh, our brain releases endorphins, which makes us feel at ease. So, we don't know exactly why we laugh, but it makes us feel good, especially in social groups. However, this does not explain why we sometimes laugh when we're all alone, or why you might just get the giggles when you think of a past funny experience. Maybe laughing is just a way for your body to boost morale and make itself feel better. Number 16 is an action your body does that is connected to your emotions. You may be a little embarrassed when we tell you about this one. When you blush, your face turns red. We know how it turns red, but we have no idea why it happens. The reddening of the face that's connected to blushing happens when the capillaries near the surface of the skin expand and let more blood rush through the area. However, this does not explain why our body makes this happen. One reason might be to serve as an identifying factor for liars. If someone in your social group is lying, they might blush, and if they get caught, it could cause them to blush even more. It's been suggested that the most likely reason for blushing occurs as a social cue. Interestingly, research has shown that blushing is a positive behavior in social interactions. Maybe this is because people who blush may be considered more trustworthy since they have such an obvious tell if they're lying. Charles Darwin even called blushing the most peculiar and most human of all expressions, because even though we can explain how blushing occurs, we really have no idea why our bodies do it. This brings us to something our body does that seems so simple yet is shrouded in mystery. Number 15 on our list is, why do we sleep? At a basic level, we might just assume our body needs sleep so we can rest. But our body can rest without falling asleep. So, why do we sleep at all? Almost every animal sleeps in some form, whether it's short naps or long stretches at night. This process seems important to all animals. But why is it necessary? When you think about it, falling asleep is really dangerous if you live somewhere there are predators trying to hunt and eat you. When you sleep, you're unaware and vulnerable. So it would stand to reason that natural selection would eventually get rid of this dangerous process, but that hasn't been the case. Most scientists think sleep is a way to recharge the brain and allow the body to build up stores of energy. It may also be a way for us to transfer information and memories into different parts of the brain. It's even been suggested that sleep is necessary to bring brain cells back to a baseline state so that the brain doesn't overload. However, the fact remains that we are not entirely sure why we sleep. And for number 14, we're going to take things one step further. Why do you dream? If sleep may be used to reset your brain cells, why does your brain then create vivid stories for you to experience while you sleep? Again, we don't actually know why our bodies do this. It has been proposed that dreams are the way your brain regulates mood or catalogs the events of the day. On the other hand, some scientists suggest that dreams are just an accidental side effect of your neurons firing. We spend up to a third of our lives sleeping and dreaming, yet we do not know actually why. For number 13, we're going to talk about how weak you are. You may be offended, but it's not just you, it's all humans. The human body is surprisingly weak when compared to our closest relatives. If you put a chimpanzee and a human next to each other, you would see more similarities than differences. We share over 98% of our DNA with chimps, so on a biological level, we are absolutely more similar than different. But when we look at the strength of a chimp versus that of a human, we are so much weaker. Our bodies have most of the same muscles, but chimps' bodies are 3 times stronger than ours. And the crazy thing is, we just don't know why we are such weaklings. It may have to do with the way our muscles attach to each other. In the wild, an 85-pound chimp was seen easily snapping branches from an ironwood tree with her fingertips. However, when a human tried to do the same thing using both of their hands, they couldn't break that very same type of branch. It is still a mystery why our bodies are so embarrassingly weak when compared to our closest relatives. And talking about hands, number 12 has to do with our body having a peculiar trait in these appendages. It is unclear why humans have a dominant hand at all. The vast majority of humans are right-handed, but why? And what does that say about left-handed people? Many scientists think it has something to do with the speech center of the brain. This is found in the left hemisphere, which controls the right side of the body. There may be a connection between speech and having a dominant hand, but other research shows that not all right-handed people control their speech from the left hemisphere. So what it comes down to is we have no idea why our body has a dominant hand. There's also no explanation for number 11 on our list. Why do we have fingerprints? Yes, they are unique, and yes, they can be used to identify someone, but what function do they serve? For a long time, we thought that our fingerprints helped us grip things, but this has been shown to not be the case. It's been suggested that maybe the fingerprints allow us to have more sensitivity when touching things, but this has not been proven yet. As of right now, we'll just have to accept that our hands are still somewhat of a mystery to us. As we get into the top 10 things we don't understand about your body, things are going to get pretty out there. You are definitely special, and besides fingerprints, there are other differences between you and every other human on the planet. For example, why do humans have so many different eye colors? We know that the color of your eyes is determined by your genes and the pigments that are created by the cells in your eyes. But why do we need blues, greens, browns, or a combination of these colors? Maybe it's just to make our eyes pretty. But we really don't know why eye color is so varied. This goes for number 9 on our list as well. Why do we have different blood types? It would be much more convenient for doctors and medical professionals if we all had the same blood type. But this is not the case. It is true that some blood types are more resistant to certain infections than others. Therefore, one type of blood may have been beneficial in a certain part of the world, and a different type might have been better adapted to another. Since humans evolved in Africa and spread across the globe, different blood types may have been a byproduct of the process of natural selection for different environments, but we aren't 100% sure. Continuing with your special characteristics, number 8 and 7 have to do with the hair, or lack thereof, on your body. Hair color varies greatly, but there is something else about hair we don't quite understand. Why do we need it on our bodies at all? Hair on the head and face definitely serve a purpose, but what about body hair? We do not grow enough body hair to make a significant difference in temperature regulation. At one point in our distant past, humans had much more body hair, which would keep us warm or help in cooling us off, but today it's hard to find someone with enough body hair to make that much of a difference. If you lost all of your hair tomorrow, you wouldn't miss it. Well, at least not in terms of any biological reasons. So we don't exactly know why we still grow body hair. This brings us inside of your body for number 6 on the list. You have trillions of little creatures living inside you right now. In fact, the microbes in your body may outnumber your own cells about 10 to 1. That's crazy. We know that some of the bacteria in your body helps you with digestion and other life functions, but this is just a small percentage of the whole. So why does your body allow trillions of microbes to live within it? We don't know. The study of the human microbiome is a relatively new field, and we are still learning. But for right now, you're home to an entire ecosystem of microbes, and we have no idea why most of them are there. And now we hope you're ready for number 5, which is a little gross when you think about it, so hopefully you didn't just eat a big meal. We don't actually know how all those microbes got inside you in the first place. You were definitely born with some, and you pick up others through food, water, and even the air you breathe. But everyone's microbiome is different. So how does your body gather its unique group of microbes? No one really knows. However, when you sleep with someone, you are probably swapping more than just pleasure and bodily fluids. You're also exchanging microbes. Think about that next time you hook up with someone. You probably heard of number 4 on our list. It's commonly thought that your appendix serves no purpose. You may even be in the 1 in 15 people who have had their appendix removed. So why does your body even have the organ? Some scientists think it's just a vestigial structure left over from our evolutionary ancestors. Others believe that it still serves a function in the development of the fetus, or is useful for producing certain proteins and hormones that could be beneficial to our bodies. But the fact that you can live without it begs the question, why is it even there? We honestly don't know why. This brings us to the end of our list. Our last 3 unexplained phenomena in your body come from the same place, the brain. To start us off, we have no idea how the brain actually works. We know there are trillions of neural connections that work together to keep you alive and allow you to watch the insanely interesting videos put out by the Infographics show. But really, we don't know how the brain actually functions as a whole. The brain is made up of atoms and molecules just like everything else in the universe, yet it is the only thing we know of that can control a body, think, and even dream. Number 2 on our list is that we don't know how your brain allows you to react and move with ease. No one can explain how your brain is able to move billions of cells in an instant. Also, how do the chemical reactions that keep you alive and moving on a day-to-day basis even occur? Doing something as simple as typing a few words into a computer requires massive amounts of signals from your brain to your fingers. You also need your eyes to see and send information about where the buttons are. All of that information is fed to the brain, which must then interpret it and send out new signals in a split second. We have no idea how your brain can make your body do exactly what you want in only tenths of a second. Finally, we're at the end of our list of things your body does that we just don't understand, and we're going to get pretty metaphysical. What makes you, you? Well, your DNA is responsible for your traits, but your consciousness is responsible for who you are and your personality. How does your body create consciousness? We have absolutely no idea. It probably comes from the brain, but we aren't even 100% sure of that. You could go down a deep, dark rabbit hole trying to figure out what consciousness is, where it comes from, and why your body creates it, or you could just chalk it up to being something else your body does that we don't yet understand. Now watch What Happens to Your Body After You Die, or check out Crazy Things a Doctor Removed from Inside a Person's Body.